Hello everyone, welcome to Skills Build Training YouTube channel. Myself Mohammed Zubair, and this channel is all about showing you how to become an IT pro really fast. So the topic of today's video is Ubuntu Budgie review and first thoughts. So without any further ado, let's get started. In today's video, I'll be reviewing the Ubuntu Budgie in detail, and at the end, I will have my thoughts about this Linux distribution. So first of all, let's start with the release date. Well, Ubuntu Budgie 21.04 got released in April 2021, and it will be supported till Jan 2022. If we talk about the hardware requirements, which are needed to install Ubuntu Budgie in your system, it needs 4 GB of RAM and recommended space is 10 GB. That is the minimum requirement. You can go beyond that as well. Now, let's start with Ubuntu Budgie itself. Ubuntu Budgie, as the name says, is a flavor of Ubuntu, officially using the Budgie desktop environment. This flavor is the newer member of Ubuntu family. Ubuntu Budgie 16.04 was the first release, but it was accepted as the official flavor with the 17.04 release. This version of Ubuntu Budgie has come up with the latest version of Budgie desktop, which is 10.5.2. Now, as you can see on your screen, that we have a welcome screen. And here we have a lot of options, and here you can see we have introductions, we have features, getting started, recommendations, then we have online stores, community and other things as well. If I go into install software, here you can see it gives further options. We have Budgie extras, we will have recommendations, and in those recommendations it will recommend us to download or install some software which will enhance the performance of our Ubuntu Budgie. Down here, we have Software Center, which is by default. And from here, you will be able to download a lot of applications and software. Then we have Snap Apps and Flatpak Apps. So I will click on Budgie Extra here. And here you can see we have different extensions, or you can say different applets, which we can install or we can add into our Budgie desktop environment. I'll go back, and now I will again click on install software, and this time I'll click on recommendations. And here you can see it says backports repository, Dropbox, and down here we have several other things which are recommended to us to install into our Ubuntu Budgie. And obviously, if we install this, we will have more enhanced performance of our Ubuntu Budgie distribution. So I will go back again now. The other main option here is themes and layout. I will talk about this at the end of this video. At the moment, I will talk about the rest of the options. Here we have the features. What we will get here, you will get all the information about the features which are available in Ubuntu Budgie. And down here, you have getting started. If you click on it, here you will have a lot of options, or you can say you will be able to do a lot of things. As here you can see, we have browser palette, customization, keyboard shortcuts. Keyboard shortcuts mean you can set different shortcuts to open different application or to perform different functions on your Ubuntu Budgie distribution. And here we have a section which says post installation. And down here we have updates and extras. And here we'll be able to see all those updates which are yet to be done or which are yet to be installed in our Ubuntu Budgie. And down here we have drivers, means as the name says, we will have all the information about the drivers, then language, and then optional task. I will click on updates and extra. So I will click on it, and here I will check that how much updates are required in my system. So I will just click on it, and here you can see it is checking for the updates. After that, it will show me the list or the information that how much space do I need to install the remaining or needed updates. And here you can see it says 380.6 MB will be downloaded. It means my updates need this much space to get installed into my system. I'm not going to do it. I will do it later. So I will click on remind me later. And now let's go back. Now let's go to drivers here. I will just click on it. And here we will have all the information about our drivers. Here it says additional drivers. And down here we have other information as well. So that was all about the welcome screen, and we are only left with themes. So as I told you earlier that I will talk about it at the end of today's video. So I will just minimize this screen, and now let's go to the about section of Ubuntu Bungee. For that, I will press my super key and then I will write here about, and here it is. I will just click on it, and here we have all the information about our Ubuntu Bungee. Here you can see operating system name is Ubuntu 21.04, GNOME version is 3.38.5, and windowing system is X11. And this is all the information about our Ubuntu Bungee. And here we have several other options in our settings, and these are all similar to any other Ubuntu based Linux distribution. We do get all these options which are available here in almost every Ubuntu based Linux distribution. Now what I'm going to do, I will just close it, and now let's discuss a very important thing here, and that is icon tray. As you can see, we have an icon tray and we have different icons of different applications in here. What I'm going to do now, I will right click here, and now I'll go to the preferences. Just click on it, and here we can do different tweaks with respect to our icon tray. At the moment, our theme is transparent, which is by default here. You can choose any other from the available here. You can go for the GTK Plus, and you can go for the matte as well. You can change the positioning as well. At the moment, it is at the bottom. You can go with left, right, top as well. And here we have primary color, and then alignment, and down here we have icon size. You can increase the size. As you can see, as I am changing the size of my icon also getting changed. Now I'll go back to default, which was I think 32, and here we have behavior. If I click on it, here you can see we have an option which is hide dock. What it means, let me show you. I will open my files. Here it is. I will just open it. Just look at the top bar. At the moment, it is transparent. If I maximize this window or my file manager, I will double click on it. Here you can see the color of my top bar has been changed. Earlier, it was transparent, and now it has changed itself into dark mode. And that is the meaning of hide dock. I will close my files. And here we have other things as well. And here we have docklets, etc. I will close this one. The most important thing, or you can say the thing which should be reviewed here, and that is desktop setting. We have two ways to open our desktop setting. First one is to right click on your screen and then go to your desktop setting. Other one is go to your application menu and just write desktop settings. And here you can see we have the option here. We have a lot of customization options. You can do a lot of customization with respect to your desktop. At the moment, we are under the style section. For the appearance of our widgets, we have selected the dark theme. If I go with the light one, and here you can see the appearance got changed. I'll go back to the dark because I like the dark one. And down here, we have the icons. At the moment, we have the Pokilo, which is by default selected. You can go with any other as well. So if I go with the humanity, you can see our icons got changed. I'm going with the Pokilo again. And then you can set your cursor, and down here you have your notification positioning. At the moment it is top right, which is right here. I will talk about this as well, so I will leave it here. And here you have a dark theme, built-in theme, and then animations. And here we have desktop section. If I click on it, here you can do a lot of stuff with your desktop, and then you can have different fonts selected for your desktop environment, or you can say for your Ubuntu Bungee. And then we have Raven, then Windows, and this is the most important thing, and that is top panel. If I click on it, this is the top panel which I'm talking about. And here you can see you have different icons and different stuff there. First one is app menu, which is this one. Then we have our spacer, which is this one. And then we have our clock, which is this one. And then we have our visual space, app indicator applet, drop by, quick notes, spacer. Then we have our places, and then we have several other options here. This is the visual space. As you can see, we have a circle which is filled, and then we have another circle which is not filled. It means we have two virtual desktop available at the moment. If you want to increase these virtual desktop, just click on it. And here you have upper arrow and down arrow. Just click on upper arrow and you can see we have number of circle increased. Now, what if you want to switch between different virtual desktop? For that, just press Ctrl plus Alt and then use your right and left arrow keys. And as you can see on your top, if I press my right arrow key, you will see my circle on the right side will get filled up. Here it is. Now I will press my left key and it will move backwards. And now we are on our default virtual desktop. And here we have our quick note, which is this one. If you talk about its functionality, just click on it. What you can do here, you can write different notes here, and it is just like the sticky notes in your Windows. If I write here, hello, now I will close this one. If I again click on it, it will again start from where I left. So that is all about quick notes. Then we have down here spacer, and here you can see we have places here, and here is the icon of places on our top bar. If I click on it, what it will do, it will allow me to go to the common, or you can say the most used places in my system. And these are the most common, or you can say most appropriate places, which are documents. Then we have our downloads, music, pictures, and videos. So if I click on any one of these, it will take me to that directory. Now let's go back. And last one is the notification. In most of the Ubuntu based Linux distribution, we have the notification with our clock here. If you click on it, you have a window here in which you have all the notification along with an option to mute or disable your notification. But in Ubuntu Budgie, we have a separate section, or you can say separate icon for our notification. And here it is, the bell icon. If you click on it, here you will have all the notification with respect to your machine, or you can say with respect to your system. And last but not the least is this icon. If you click on it, here you have a different option, or you can say here you have different widgets, like we have calendar, and then we have our volume, and down here we have our apps and devices, and this is to set up your mic volume. The shortcut to open this option is press your super key and then press A. Here you can see it is opening with super key plus A button. So that was all about Budgie desktop settings. One very important thing which I want to discuss here, let me close this one first. If you remember, in Ubuntu based Linux distribution, we get applications icon docked on the left side. But in Ubuntu Budgie, we do not have this option. But the good news is we can do this thing. For that, just go to your application menu and select any application and just drag it and drop it on the desktop. Now I will go again. I will look for the Firefox. Here it is. I will drag it and I will drop it on the desktop. Now let's do one more, and this time I'm going for terminal. Here it is. In Ubuntu Budgie, terminal is here with the name of Tilex. I will drag it and I will drop it on my desktop. Now, how to align these applications on the left side or in one line? For that, just right click on your screen, and here we have an option which says align to grid. Just click on it, and here you can see we have our application's icon aligned on the left side. And for many people, this is the more appropriate option than having a menu tray icon on the bottom of your screen. In case if you want to delete this icon, just select all of them, right click on it, and then just click on delete. And now again click on delete, and you are done with deleting those icons. So that was all about the desktop and different things which you can do with respect to the desktop. Now let's check if we have top or edge top available or not in our Ubuntu Budgie. For that, I need to open my terminal. Here it is. I will open it, and here I will write top, hit enter. Yes, we do have top available in our Ubuntu Budgie. I will get out of it. To get out of it, just press Ctrl plus Z button. Now, I will check if we have htop available or not. For that, I will just write htop and hit enter. Yes, we do have htop available. Well, this is a command which helps you to get the information about your system resources. As you can see, at the moment my CPU is at 32, 40 and 38%. It is giving me different readings. And then I have my memory which says 1.24 gigabytes has been used. And down here we have our swap value. And then here we have our task, load average and uptime. And these are different processes which are running at the moment. And this is the information about the user, mean who is the user of these processes. Because at the moment, I have two users in my Ubuntu Budgie. First one is root and second one is Uber. With top, we get this information as well, but we do not get this color scheme and we do not get this information in arranged manner. But with htop, we get all this information in more arranged way and in more sophisticated way. So I will just close this one. Now, let's open our software center. I will just click on it. And here, we will have all the softwares which we can download and install into our system. And down here, we have the categories. Like you can see here, we have audio, video, games, developer tools, communication and news. And we have several other options here as well. So what you can do, you can search your particular software or application by category as well here. And here you will have all the information about installed software or application. As I have told you earlier that we have Snap and Flatpak available in Ubuntu Budgie. So it means we'll be able to download a lot more applications and software as we have both those repositories enabled by default in our Ubuntu Budgie distribution. If you remember, I told you that I'll come to the themes at the end of today's video. So let's go there. And here is our Ubuntu Budgie welcome screen. I will go to my themes and layouts. So what you can do, you can use different themes for your desktop. I'm going to use Pokilo at the moment. For that, I'll click on apply makeover. But as you can see, we have a small down arrow. If you click on it, what it will allow you to use individual things from this theme. If you only want to use theme, you can go for that. If you only want to use fonts, you can go that as well. And if you only want to use icon, you can select the icon. But if you want to use the whole theme, just click on apply makeover. I'm going with the art design, so I will just click on apply makeover. And here you can see we have our desktop changed. After scrolling up, you have another option which says desktop layout. If you click on it, what it will show you different options which you can select for your desktop. If you scroll down, we have all our menus, or you can say we have all our widgets on the bottom side. At the moment, you can see we have all these things at the top, but with this theme, we will have all these things on the bottom. I will scroll down again. And here you can see we have the one in this. We have all these things on the left side of our window. I'm going over this one. For that, I'll just click on apply layout. And you will see all these things on the left side on my screen. And here you can see we have all our application icons appeared on the left side on our window. And this is just like any other Ubuntu based Linux distribution in which we get all our application icon or the applications which we have selected on the left side of our window. And now if we see the default applications in our Ubuntu Budgie, we have Mozilla Firefox as the default browser. For email client, let's see what do we have. If I write here email, so the Thunderbird Mail is the application for emailing. If we talk about the applications for our documents, let's see if we have LibreOffice or not. Yes, we do have LibreOffice available in our Ubuntu Budgie. I will close this one. And these are the applications which are by default in our Ubuntu Budgie. I'll go back and we have Budgie Welcome, Calculator, we have Calendar, then we have Celluloid, which is Music Player. And then let's go further. Here you can see we have our Mozilla Firefox, then we have Disk, for partitioning, and here we have our LibreOffice, and then we get a lot of other applications in our Ubuntu Budgie as well. For some people, this might be good because some people love to use and love to have a lot of application, but for some people, this might not be a good thing because they only want to have those applications which they need or want. And that brings us to the end of review. If we talk about my thoughts about Ubuntu Budgie, I would say this is the best Ubuntu-based Linux distribution I have used till now because it is a very refreshing and it is very pleasing to the eyes. And apart from that, everything which we have seen till now in Ubuntu Budgie is self-explanatory. We do not have to look for something particular with any difficulty. You can search with common words and you will see every result out of it. I would say that anyone who are planning to shift from a Windows or Mac operating system to Ubuntu or Linux distributions, I would recommend them to use Ubuntu Budgie for once at least, because it is very easy to use and it is very customizable, as we have done a lot of customization in this video. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope you have learned something new and you have liked this video. If that is the case, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon as well. If you have something to ask, please leave a comment below. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Till the next video, take care.